This is Not the Average Real Estate Podcast by Not Your Average Real Estate Investor. Dipna Boholt used real estate investing strategies to completely replace the income from her accountancy practice with passive income in just 18 months and has since taught thousands of others to do the same. Welcome to the I Love Real Estate Podcast.
Hi there, it's Dipna here. Thanks for joining me on my ride. I'm obviously in a car. We're heading down to Fremantle at the moment. And I thought I'd share with you a series that I'm doing at the moment. And this series is really exposing some of my students and what they've been able to do in what space of time. So I've got this series coming out and I'm so pleased you can join me on this episode. And I want to share with you a story that was recorded at a live event that we did at the end of last year. And it was the I Love Real Estate Super Conference. It's a fantastic event where we get all these students to come on stage and share what they did and how they transformed their lives as part of I Love Real Estate. And it's so motivational, so much fun. And I thought it'd be really great to share it with everybody because it really shows you what is possible and how quickly your lives can turn around with the proper education and some really strategic planning. Now, the story that I want to share with you today is a story of Sanjay and Ila. Now, they weren't born in this country, and they started with as little as $20,000 when they first started investing. Unfortunately, they went down the wrong track. So by the time they joined I Love Real Estate, they had a total equity of about $90,000. So they had a couple of properties, but they didn't own very much of them. The bank owned most of it. And of course, they were negative cash flow as well. So by joining I Love Real Estate, they were able to turn that around and actually produce 10 times the equity. So in the space of about 4 years, not even that, I think, it was around $900,000 in equity and over $60,000 in passive income. And with the deals they've got in play right now, their passive income this year will be $90,000, and Sanjay will be able to give up work and be full-time real estate. And for many of you, that would be a fantastic goal to achieve in 3 to 4 years. So have a listen to his story. I know you're gonna love it. And I'll come back on the other side. Now, when I come back, I've got a special gift for you so that you can get the kind of results that Sanjay and Ila were able to get. So I'll see you on the other side.
Bye. You're a bit scared, aren't you? Well, put that up microphone on your chin. Yeah. There we go. Okay. Well, look, Mickey T's here to help you and support you through the process.
Yep.
Yeah? You ready?
Yes. How are you guys?
Now, that's your little girl climbing the steps, hey?
Yes.
And that's what it's like in real estate, is just take the first step, then the next one, then the next one. So I thought that was great when you put that on your slide. So where are you living? Where's your base?
So we are Sydney based.
Put that on your chin.
We are Sydney based.
Sydney based, okay. So what do you think of Melbourne?
Great.
You have to say that because we're down here in Melbourne.
It's a bit different, like it's very windy, a little bit cold, but
yeah. It's different. It's got a different feel about it, but yes. Both cities are beautiful. Oh. Okay, so let's go back a little bit. How did you end up finding I Love Real Estate and end up listening to me?
So we actually got introduced to you in our one-day free event in Sydney, which only Sanjeev attended because I was pregnant 6 months.
Right.
With my first child. And he was so pumped up. He was so inspired on the day. He called me in the afternoon from the seminar, actually. And he said, like, yay, this is the way to go. Because we were looking for some options to make some other option, like income option. And he was so pumped, inspired. And he said, like, no, do we have to go? Like, he explained a bit to me. And
so you didn't want to come?
Again, no, I want to come. So I said, yeah, let's go. Let's make a decision and then let's sign up for the quantum. Mm-hmm. And he said, I already did it.
You naughty boy.
I was used to use credit card, so it's not a big deal for me.
Well, at least this was for the good cause. So your starting position was that you had your own home and you had an investment property, but you had credit card debt and a whole lot of other things. So really very flush, were you?
Yeah, so pretty much we were like looking for other way of income and like wanted to get out of the job. I think that was my first priority. I wanted to help my parents when they grow old, actually, so that I can spend time, not just send them a couple of $100 and money, but wanted to give my time. And they were overseas, and definitely they can come here, but they don't feel comfortable for so many reasons.
Sure.
So that was my main thing, and that's what I started looking. So when we started, I think we had in 2015, we started with you in August with the free day event, and straight away we signed for Quantum. And at that point, we had just moved to our PPR in Sydney, which we had bought 1.5 years ago. And same year, we had bought a one-bedroom unit in the similar area of the plan, which was due to settle in end of 2016. Mm-hmm. And we had paid 10%, which was $35,000. Yeah, and we had $25,000 due on credit card for our expenses. And because we didn't have
any... So not a really good starting position. Yeah. And like most investors who want to be investors, they start with... buying an off-the-plan deal. Now, obviously, when the market's moving, it might be okay, but when the market's not moving or it goes the other way, you can get very, very hurt doing that kind of strategy. So, I mean, the cash flow there, we've got zero. In fact, it was negative because you're paying the mortgage on your own home, you're paying potentially the mortgage on the other one when that settles, and you're paying the interest on the credit card. So cash flow must have been pretty tight.
Yep.
At that stage, were you both working?
Yes, we were a full-time job and... And that's what we signed up. We had the end of October, we had the boot camp, 3 days, so which gave us like a lot of hope and inspiration. And we said, oh my God, with other can do it, we can do it. So that's what we made the decision. It was first decision was the one-day event, which I think was one of the best decision of our life, which you guys will see. And then in the boot camp, we decided that... We'll go out, and at that time we had 20,000 because after signing up, after listening to the webinars, we thought, okay, we'll get out some equity because we have to close the credit card, and we were getting disciplined, of course, pay for the education and other stuff, right? So that time we had $20,000, our serviceability was around 200,000. So as you know, like we Dimnos is like, you know, that look for a place where it's a number game, so what you can afford and where you can buy. Mm-hmm. So all we, from the place we were living, we could had bought in 120 kilometers away.
Yeah.
So that's what we started looking, and pretty much started going all the weekends, started building the team, talking to the professionals. There was no compromise on that, even we didn't have money in our pocket. So we did that, and then what happened is soon, I think, within a month time, we started looking great deals, like, and there was a lot of competition, and people are coming because that's a good sign that you're looking at a good deal. Mm-hmm. And but the speed to market was very slow. By the time we talked to the council or town planner, because we were learning, because we had no experience, like hardly without before the boot camp, I was not knowing what exactly the council does, actually, even we had bought the house.
We heard the first time that the something is town planner.
Yes.
Yeah. So you got a little bit of education from the boot camp, and you got into a small deal. It was a joint venture deal on a small land subdivision.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, and you picked up a little bit of money. I mean, you know, this is often the case. The first deal that you do, particularly if it's a smaller deal, you make a little bit of money, but you learn the process. You learn the team. You know, you learn who's going to be in your team. You learn the what who does what in your team, all that kind of stuff. So great starter. Yeah. So you're on the road.
Yes.
Okay.
And then we bought this subdivision deal, and then with the joint venture, and we bought the land and subdivided, and the subdivision was done only for $2,000, actually.
Wow, very good.
Because everything was already there. We spoke to we had the right team, and then later the joint venture partner sold his. So each lot costed us $50,000 only, because we bought for $85,000, and we got each of my joint venture got one lot, and we got one lot.
Mm-hmm.
So I hold it to build, mm-hmm. and joint venture sold it for $80,000 in next financial year.
Okay, very good.
So
that's a start.
Which was a good start. It gave us a lot of faith. Mm-hmm. And like, okay, we were pumped up, like we can do anything. And so...
As you can, good headset, good mindset.
And then, yeah, 12,000 was back because we had more money. So, and then we said, okay, now we'll look for... because we can do subdivision, we can do a build. Of course, we didn't have the serviceability, so we said, okay, now we have the land. So we started looking for... another deal, which was another 150 kilometers away from, and we now looking into the center of the CBD with a good population of like around 40,000-50,000 people in the center, where we can do multiple options because we didn't have money, so we always looking like how we can
club
many opportunities into one, and that's what we found this deal where we bought a ugly duckly 4-bedroom solid house with 1 bathroom. And we converted, we did a good renovation with, spent around $50,000, 4-bedroom, and converted into 1.5 bathroom also, because we wanted to do room by room rent for the cash flow, because, and then we, this is the property, and we
so
had
the
like,
cash flow came in quite well. You're getting $11,000 positive cash flow now on that one.
Yes, and it's all managed by the agent, and it, these are the conservative figures.
So that's a relatively low entry point, you know, under $300,000 to get in. You get an $11,000 cash flow, and because of the renovation that you did after costs and everything, you still pick up another $51,000.
Yes, yeah.
So it's a, take the first step, take the next step. So you're moving forward, even though they're small ones to start with, you know, the movement forward, you start to get some traction. And you get confidence through that as well.
Yes. So because I was going through the length, so my main motivation was that I want to learn everything, do myself, so that if you want to go big, you have to know the basics. So even we both were full-time job, we had the baby also towards the end of December in 2015. We were like, of course, my wife was supporting me all the way, otherwise... it could have been impossible, I would say. Going all the weekends region, like, yeah, pretty much 5 days hectic job, both of us, and then all the weekend we'll be in regional town, and like 150 kilometers. Now it's,
so there's a lot of traveling.
Yeah.
You know, and that, and it, we're talking about sacrifice now, and that's a case, again, for a lot of people with you've got to make sacrifices. It's delayed gratification. You've got to do stuff today so you can have more in the future. So that was good. So the next one we went on to was a build with a granny flat.
Yes. Okay. So this is on the first land which we got hold it. So we said, okay, now because my wife was back to work, so we said, okay, we have now some serviceability.
Serviceability to be able to build now,
yeah,
right?
And a bit of equity also from here and there, from the PPR, from the Renault deal. So we said, okay, let's go. And in this area, generally, everyone will build like normal 4-bedroom house. It will end up like 400 and you'll get rent of 370. I said, no, that's not acceptable for us, right?
Because good boy.
we wanted to get out the job, right? So neutral or negative, definitely. We didn't know negative any day, which was awesome. So we built like a house with granny.
So the house with the granny flat, was that under the one roof or was it a separate building for the granny flat?
Same, under the same roof.
Good. So that cuts your cost down. If you're going to build anyway, you may as well build it that way as a dual occupancy under the one roof. Good.
Yeah, so we built it. Okay. The land was cheap for us because it was...
part of the subdivision.
Said, okay.
Yeah.
And,
okay. So that's what you did with it? Yeah.
So, the construction cost comes 410 and now if the rent is like 630. We have just settled and we have got the keys and So
positive cash flow, another 10 grand?
Another 10 grand, yeah.
Fantastic.
And equity of 140, so.
Okay, so now you're back in the movement forward. You can see how your manufactured growth is really starting to happen.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
And, we learned like subdivision, renovation, development going to the builders and there's a process, right? And having the team and so forth. So it was like, okay, good. Now
you're on the road.
Yes.
All right, so this is your off-the-plan one, which I probably didn't approve of very much.
Yeah.
you rode the growth, so that's good, but, it's not
we had
kind of property
bought,
you want
it
to keep.
It was pre-education. I mean, would have never bought it, right? But one good mistake we did is, like, we bought in the first release without knowing it, and that's why we got this much. And we spoke to our the A-team, which is Wisdom Econ, Home Loans, and all the Pacific Law, and we use pretty much... entire team here, right? So we did the opportunity cost analysis and we decided, okay, because this was neutral, we kept it for 1 year and we decided no point keeping it and then it's better to sell and use this much money because, we can do much better things and keep moving. So that's what we sold.
And that's really what Andrew was talking about before, about the fact that, even though, yes, they've made good money on it, and that's fantastic because the market was moving with them, holding a negatively geared investment property may hold them back to be able to finance into the next deal. So, okay. Next deal. What was that?
So this one was this year, actually. So this year, so last year I got a promotion also. Looking at my energy,
very good.
My boss said, I think you need a promotion. I said, oh my God, now I have to do more work. So, but then I said, okay, we'll have a bit of extra serviceability to buy more property. So let's take it positive. And this year what happened is pretty much five months, I got into a project for the company. Was full hectic, like from pretty much 8:30 to 7 o'clock, I'll be working and I have no time to take a call. I'd be like, okay. So I thought, okay, we had the PPR because it will be hard for regional and all. So we said, okay, we are sitting already in our PPR. It's a four-bedroom house with 2.5 bathroom, new house in a great location. Mm-hmm. Let's convert this one into, and it has two living areas also, so we can easily convert it into a five-bedroom with three bathroom. Mm-hmm. So we did that and did room by room rent.
Very good. So nicely positive there, 20 grand. So
yes. Again.
Are you thinking about giving up work at this stage? Not yet.
Not
Maybe
yet.
Your wife is. Might be Ella's turn first.
Yeah. So again, we set it up. So pretty much this property has got like 40-inch TV in each room. It's a good house. Again, we went to the agent and educated them, shown mm-hmm. our energy and passion and a win-win situation, and they are managing for us. So, yeah, again, leveraging is the key, I think.
Very good. So now you're into a subdivision with a build and a room-by-room rent.
Yes.
So woohoo. All right.
So this one, we gone to our second deal where we already renovated and did the room-by-room rent. Mm-hmm. But I think, we didn't mention that has the subdivision opportunity also. Mm. Because I didn't have the money. So I said, okay, I'll do everything in one deal. So this has the potential to subdivide. So now we know that four-room is running 200. Running successfully, mm-hmm. why not we build a five-bedroom with four-bathroom?
Okay.
We look at the exit strategy also so that if we have to sell for some reason in the future, then five-bedroom, four-bathroom, I think even family would be able to buy. And so this one, we have just done the DA, mm-hmm. and and we are hoping to get the approval by end of this month, mm-hmm. and construction to start next year. Yeah.
So you'll make the uplift on the subdivision as well as the construction, yeah. and being $150,000, which is pretty good for that kind of deal.
Yeah.
And it'll be positive cash flow. Now, that cash flow would be just on the house as it is.
Yes.
So when you get the other one completed, what would be cash flow estimate on that, do you think?
Yeah, so this will be 22K.
That will be 22 with the other, with the construction.
With the construction, just alone this one. Because the first one is doing 10, 11, 12K.
Yep. Yep.
But this one itself, because all we have, land is free, right?
Yeah.
So it's just the 350 for the DA and the construction, and we are looking like brand new, right? With four bathroom, 40-inch TV, I'm going to give, right? Big fridge. So 210, right? Easy sell. And there's a demand. There's a good demand. Same agent, easy sell.
Very good. So we talk about more important things than real estate. I mean, obviously you've done well, you know, you're working on income replacement. Everything that you've kept now has been positive cash flow. You're still in reasonably good growth areas or ladder ones particularly. What are some of the other things that have come out of joining I Love Real Estate?
So, yeah, financially we got at this stage, we are here. But more than that, I think we had a huge transformation within ourselves from the decision, everyday decision, what we eat, what we talk, what we think. We have like daily rituals. Like I think this is last couple of years I've cried more than any day. I think not because of fear or anything, but more of the gratefulness and what we're doing and where we're going. At the same time, looks like what the goal we had, like initially when we joined, our goal was that looking at the cases and other people, even though it was hard to say, but we put a date saying, oh, I want to get out in 4 or 5 years. And end of next year will be our 4 year
yes.
to this. Even we stopped doing any other deals, just finish this off. And there are a few opportunities in our deal, like even with the house granny,
yes.
we can, if we do a room by room rent, which we have built in such a way, another 10,000 will be coming. So I think, yeah.
So you're getting pretty close.
Very close. And then, yeah, I think the big deals are waiting for us. And I want to get out of the job. It's a hectic job, I think. Even my wife has got a hectic job and we have a baby. So we want to get out of so that we can do better things and then spend the time. I think that's our why.
Yeah.
And when my mom calls, right, I don't say, oh, how are you? Take a medicine. No, I want to take a flight and see her tomorrow. So.
No, very good, very good.
Okay,
so what are some of the learnings that you've had along the way?
Lot of learnings, but pretty much from zero, right? What does counsel does, I don't know. And now it's like I'm considered to be expert from all my friends. And I'm a good person, so yeah, you talk to me about any deals, I'll mm-hmm. talk. I'll do it. So that's big on the property side. And yeah, so pretty much we have applied successfully all the basic knowledge, what we learned in quantum, extreme income, fast profit, you talked mm-hmm. about. The best part we have done is like we learned to build our A team. I think that's the very key. Of course, education and mentor is the top one, but then building the A team. Because I remember like we had $20,000 and like I have to pay for anything $500,000 and I'm using the best professionals, right? And that time, I don't have money, that's my problem, but I have to still pay if you want. And that helped us. Like, we were going through a pain, but I was knowing that it's something I have to pay. Follow the mentors. We had the full faith on ourselves and the education that pay them. And what happened is I was getting the best advice, which helped us to push forward, like move forward like quickly, and helped so much that, and you learned also, like my first deal, right, or the subdivision. Before that, we had looked at 20, 30 properties. I was expert in the contract. I was the local town planner myself. When I bought that land, I didn't consult the town plan. It was so simple. I was knowing whom to talk, what to talk, and it was a done deal. But before that, definitely we paid a lot of money to have the build team and get that voice. So building a team is the crucial one. I think that will help you to go faster and avoid any pain and doing mistakes.
So what are some of the things that perhaps you could advise people not to do? You've got to listen to your friends and family.
Yeah. I think that's a big thing we did. Like we don't watch TV. We don't look to social media other than its community. And yeah, of course. I think yeah, we never listen to our even family. Like they say, oh, you're a small kid. Don't buy. Don't take loans and all. Okay, no. I want to give me more money. I want all the money. And pretty much with the friends and all. I say okay. If you have money, give me straight away 10%, I'm going to give you so that I want them to call me, right? Because I need money all the time to complete.
Well, what you're doing is you're leveraging it. It's yes. legal arbitrage, yes. basically, because even if you're paying somebody, 10%, you know what you can do with it to elevate the value of that money.
Yeah.
So very good. Power of leverage. So here are your final results so far. Sorry.
So one thing I was going to say, Sanjeev, when we were talking before, you were mentioning how you've put yourself in a position now where you can start to give back. And do you want to talk a little bit about how you're helping your family and your nieces?
Yes. So, I've got two nieces which they were studying in India, and I was helping from last 7-8 years from their childhood itself to get into the 4 years back they get into the higher education, and they're two similar 1 year difference, so they got into the higher education engineering at the same time. So it's a private education, it's expensive. So we said okay, now I'm overseas, so I'll help you. And what happened is we pushed and then 3 years ago, after doing these things, I think pretty much we paid for their full education. And this year, both of them has been graduated. Mm-hmm. And one has got a good job in a multinational company.
Very good.
And the second one, we are expecting to get the job any day.
Good.
So we feel so good, I think, and grateful and proud that, okay, these things are helping us to what we were thinking to make it possible, actually.
That's right. So your final results here, you've gone from having $90,000 in equity and you've got zero cash flow, and effectively it was negative cash flow because you had to pay the mortgage and other things. Equity there now of $877,000, which is good. And your strategies have been more geared towards income rather than growth. So, that's a great growth and that's fantastic, but the strategies that you've done have been geared towards income replacement because that has been your primary focus. So the increase in equity hasn't been as good perhaps as different deals would have done that, but the cash flow is there. So you're now $62,000 positive cash flow, and you say that you only need another 3 or 4 deals to actually replace your income.
Yep, maybe 2 deals, I think.
2 deals. Whoa.
All cash, and yeah. So I think that was my initial thought, like I might need 8 or 10 properties or a lot to buy, but as you're learning, and then I remember, like, you can buy, like, you can apply all the strategies in any property, right? So
yeah.
You just look for that. And that's why I always have look for such deals where I can apply because, yeah.
And I think you've got to remember it's only 3 years. You know, these guys started with a not very good position 3 years ago. And to be in that position now where you've got equity to go ahead, you've got knowledge, you've got confidence, and you've got cash flow, you know, puts you in a totally different league.
Yeah. Yeah, and not only, it's 10 times their starting position.
Absolutely.
With their equity. So they've gone from 10 times what they were in the space of 3 years, and the cash flow is actually an infinite return because they didn't have any cash flow coming through.
They
so
were negative.
How many times can you go and do that? Well, you know, it's really endless with you guys.
Yeah. Absolutely. So what advice would you give for people?
I think it's like, for us, it was taking one decision and follow like the baby. Have no fear, I think. Just have the faith in your education and yourself and just do it. Another thing is, for me, before starting, it was more of a pain, like I was not progressing through my dream and what I wanted to do. So I would say like it's one-time pain when we start. It's a pain because you're doing new things, you're new learning. It's always a pain, but it's one-time pain. But if we don't do it, we'll have the pain forever. So which is
that's true.
So I think we need to do that.
You're gone.
Thank you. Anyone sitting in the room, I think, has got everything they need to be successful in this property, right? So I think it's just applying those things and doing a smaller, like what we have done, go slowly, have the A-team, leverage them. I think these are the key things.
Mm-hmm. And of course, here's your why.
Yeah. Yes. So this is our why. My mom, my dad, and our little one. And she's with the birthday cake. She's in the...
Is that a beer bottle she's sucking?
Responsible parenting there.
Yeah. So one day I think we were one of my friends was there. We were drinking, and then she pulls and she, because kids like bottles and everything, she, oh, okay, I said, okay, we'll take your photo. We got this one.
She's not drinking, just smelling.
Oh, she's smelling, is she? Radio.
So, yeah, I think our biggest why was our parents, our kid. My wife always wanted to give the best education for our kid, and that's why.
Well, the best education for your child is your example.
Yes.
Above everything else. And, you know, now you're equipped to be able to not only be the example, but actually share that knowledge on, which makes a big difference.
Yep.
Yeah.
That was another thing, yeah. I think you wanted to lead by example. So now we are doing for all of our, we have like a big family. My brother's got 3 daughters, sister's got 3. So now we are educating all those kids, like, now. Mm-hmm. Hopefully we'll bring to this seminar one day, so I'll leave it to Padimna.
Well, very good. You've done a great job. Let's give them a big round of applause.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. So, wow, what did you think of their story? Aren't they fantastic? And, you know, there's so many stories like Ila and Sanjeev, and just what they've been able to achieve in such a short space of time is really an inspiration to all of us. You know, that kind of passive income is fantastic. And for them to be able to be planning to give up work this year, fantastic. So guys, if you'd like to get similar results, here's the gift that I promised you on the other side of that video. Now, I have set aside some time with my coaches, and I'm giving you the opportunity to experience 45 minutes free personal coaching. So what you can do is you can book in for one of these sessions. They're 45 minutes long, and the coaches will talk to you about where you're at, what you want to achieve, and how on earth you can take the steps forward to actually achieve those goals. Because that's what it's about. It's about working strategically to have your desired results. Whatever your goals are, very achievable in relatively short spaces of time, just like Ila and Sanjeev. Now, all you have to do is go to www.iloverealestate.tv
www.ecoworkers.com/apply. And there you'll see some appointment times that you can book in for your free 45-minute coaching session. It's very personal, your situation, where you want to go and how you can go about doing that. Now, I know this is going to be of enormous benefit to you. The places are limited. So you need to make sure that you book in one of those appointments. Now, remember, you go to www.iloverealestate.tv/apply. Book in for one of the sessions. Make sure you write in your diary so that you make sure that you're there and available to talk to the guys when they ring you. I know it's going to help you, and I know this is something that has really changed the lives of, you know, tens of thousands of people in the past. And here's your opportunity to make 2019-2020 one of the most magnificent times in your journey so far. So book into one of those sessions, www.iloverealestate.tv/apply, and I'll see you around the traps, guys. Bye now.